have your dicks.
It's there somewhere.
Now Jenny, your empty motor car is the greatest I declare. It's made up of bits and pieces that is picked up here and there. The engine must be ages old, but it's still got lots of power. With a gallon of scratch in the petrol tank, it goes 90 miles an hour. Oh, what's a wonderful motor car, it's the greatest ever seen. It used to be black as my father's, and now it's 40 shades of green. On TV and the radio and in every public bar, the burning question of the day is Rafferty's motor car. Now two of the wheels are triangular and the third one's off a pram. The fourth is the last remaining wheel from off a Dublin tram. The number plate's in Gaelic and the plugs won't even spark. And the chassis came off of a tinker's car that collapsed in Phoenix Park. Now go for a ride in that motor car and you'll end up with the shakes. The road from Cork to Dublin is a veil of pains and aches. When traffic lights turn red ahead, you best jump out the door. For the moment that Denny treads on the brakes, his foot will go through the floor. Oh, what a wonderful motor car, it's the greatest ever seen. It used to be black as my father's hat, now it's 40 shades of green. On TV and the radio and in every public bar, the burning question of the day is Rafferty's motor car. Seen the upholstery, your eyes would start to pop. It's nothing but empty beer crates with a load of sacks on top. The windscreen's gone to God, was wearing his muffles in the horn. And I reckon he'd only get half a quid if he took it to the pawn. Now Denny was driving around last week when the engine did the splits. It went up in smoke and nearly blew O'Connell Street to bits. They searched around for Denny and found it landed up by heck. Away up on top of the GPO with his bell placed round his neck. Oh, what a wonderful motor car, it's the greatest ever seen. It used to be black as my father's hat, now it's 40 shades of green. On TV and the radio and in every public bar, the burning question of the day is Rafferty's motor car. The burning question of the day is Rafferty's motor car. The burning question of the day is Rafferty's motor car.
Thank you. More Val Doonican later if you're lucky. Or not. Yeah, this is it's one of our own songs. This is autobiographical. Not only that, it's about our lives.
Okay. His shoes on there and he's not there.
She claimed her dad wrote the screenplay for Ben-Hur. But the lumps in my cocoa persisted longer than we did. She was the prettiest girl in ancient history. What she ever saw in me was a mystery. She was down on Exeter and she wanted to leave. I talked her down over coffee. She had the manners and tics of a lady. She even shared me her jacket, which was suede. But the lumps in my cocoa persisted longer than we did. At the end of year, ball at the Rougemont, we snuck into a room for a moment. But our amorous ambitions were thwarted by the ball gown she sported, with the seemingly endless layers of organza, taffeta, taffeta and crepe. I talked about my politics frankly, but in return she looked at me blankly. With her big doe eyes she shunned my distress about the state of the NHS. It was as if the plight of my father, the manager of a group of hospitals in the South Oxfordshire area, was of no interest to her. We went to London and sat on the tube. We floated balloons, but we didn't get rude. And the lumps in my cocoa persisted longer than we did. Then over poppadoms, pickles and chutney, we sat in stony silence and puppy. Jiminy Pease in the song. I should have left the restaurant sooner. I had a nice booner. consummation. As our relationship meandered and winded, although we had so very little in common, I wouldn't have minded. And the lonesome had cocoa persisted longer than we did. Longer than we did.
They jump on each other in nursery.
Thank you.
It is warm under the umbrella.